What's going on, everybody? Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, taking a look at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're also going to be doing a trading update, talking about what I did today on the 24th of July in 2019 in terms of my trades, as well as taking a look very quickly at the brief numbers of Tesla and Facebook, their earnings, and how those two stocks are reacting right now, as well as taking a look at some other stocks and ETFs very quickly that I'm personally watching heading into the month of August in 2019. So if you enjoy this video, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. Consider subscribing if you do enjoy stock market trading, investing, and personal finance content, and hit that notification bell, and let's get right into it, guys. So the S&P 500 today ended up hitting another all-time high at $3,019. And guys, did I not call this out when I said a couple of videos ago, if we were to break out of this downwards trending pattern, if we were to break the 50 SMA, we were most likely going to hit all-time highs, and we hit all-time highs, guys. We ended up going up 14 points today, up 0.47%. The Dow Jones actually did poorly today, down $80, down about 0.29%, and this is mostly due to Boeing, ticker symbol BA. They reported earnings earlier today. They reported, I believe, $15 billion in revenue, and they were expected to get $20 billion in revenue. So that was a huge miss on Boeing. They ended up closing down $11 today, down 3.12%, and that likely has a very heavy weight on the Dow. And if we look at the NASDAQ right now, guys, it's currently down 0.32% right now, down $25.50. But if I quickly just check my Yahoo Finance app, I can see exactly where it ended up closing, and it closed up 0.85%. Very strong green day for the NASDAQ, up 70 points. And you can see we hit a high at about $8,050 for the NASDAQ. So let's break down some technicals, guys, that I'm personally seeing in these different indexes, starting off here with the S&P 500. So it's clear at this point that we were in a head and shoulders pattern, the left shoulder, the head, the right shoulder, and we used 2975 as a launch pad to break out of that 50 SMA and to get ultimately to the all-time high that we saw today, right? In 2975, I was preaching how that level was very important, and I'm glad that we saw a double bottom and then a bullish break from there, because if we were to break that level of 2975, guys, that in my opinion would have led to more selling, potentially down to 2950. So right now, you know, the uptrend is 100% intact, right? If we take a look back on the 30-day chart and I draw a little trend line for you guys, you'll be able to see exactly what I'm talking about, right? So this proved to be a higher low from the previous low, and really the continuation on that trend as a support, and especially now that we hit the higher high, you know, everything's in line for this uptrend right now, guys. And to be honest, and I've mentioned this before, you know, when a stock or an index continues to hit all-time highs, it's kind of hard. There's really no data for a resistance, right? So now we have to see and look at old support levels or new support levels, rather, at previous all-time highs and see if the S&P is going to pull back and hold those levels as support. So let's say, you know, we gap up further tomorrow. Let's say we hit another all-time high at 30.30, for example. You know, I'd like to see if we pull back and hold that all-time high we had from a couple of days ago at about 30.15, right? I would like to see if we hold that high, previous all-time high, as a new support. And from there, if we continue the uptrend, you know, that would be nice, right? That would be pretty nice. I'm sure a lot of the bulls out there would like for that to happen, right? And if we go to the 184-hour, you guys can see exactly what I'm talking about. We need to continue to push up here. Maybe if we get a bit oversold, we might pull back and hold 30.15 as a support. So that's what I'm looking at here on the S&P 500, guys. The Dow Jones Industrial Average, it's a bit of a different story, and let me explain what I mean by that. So if we go here and draw some new drawing sets, remove old drawings. Actually, let me just do this. Remove drawing. I'll keep that one because that one's very valid right now. Remove this drawing. And if I just just draw a fresh set, you can see that right now, the Dow Jones Industrial Average is in a wedge pattern. We can see it's making higher lows at the same time it's making lower highs. You can see the all-time high at 27,400, lower high at 27,300, lower high at about 27,250, and that is where we're currently trending right now. At the same time, again, we're making higher lows, low at about 26,725, another low at about 27,130. So you guys can see exactly what I'm talking about. And right now, we need to see what direction is the Dow going to pick. Are we going to break out of the resistance of this wedge, which would be a very bullish move? That would be a bullish breakout move. Or are we going to dump, break the support, and thus break this uptrending pattern that the Dow has been on over the past couple of weeks, which would be a very bearish move in that particular scenario? So that's what I'm watching. Let's say Boeing continues to weigh down the Dow Jones. We could temporarily break this trend, and at that point, you know, we could be looking to hold maybe 27,000 flat as a new support, maybe 26,900 as a support, or even this 180 SMA here on the 20-day, one-hour chart. So that's right now, you know, what I'm watching in terms of the Dow. Which direction are we going to pick? And if we go back over here to the NQ, guys, the NASDAQ, you can see that the move we saw today was a very nice breakout move. And this was actually in a wedge. Yeah, it kind of wasn't a wedge as well. You can see the higher lows that we were making as well as the lower highs. And today, again, we broke out, hitting that all-time high, and this is a very bearish, or bullish rather, move in my opinion. We broke that, and now this could potentially pull back, retest the support, this resistance as a support, new support, and from there we can continue to push up, right? And if we go to the 20-day, one-hour chart, I'm sure you guys will be able to see it a lot better if this does decide to load. There we go. You guys can see, you know, higher lows, you know, this trend line acting as a support. At the same time, we're making lower highs as well, but today we broke out, right? That's very clear and evident that we broke out today and we hit those all-time highs. So that's kind of the market rundown at this point, guys. Let me know, what are your opinions on the market? What are you watching in terms of stocks? And let's get into what I personally did today. And honestly, guys, today I just enjoyed the FedEx gains yet again. Yesterday, I didn't really day trade. I was swing trading overnight FedEx. And today, guys, I ended up adding a little bit more to FedEx on this dip to about 175, because we can see we completed the higher high. We started to pull back, which typically happens in terms of this pattern that we've been seeing over the past couple of days. If you've noticed, every time we've hit a high, we've pulled back, right? High, pulled back, high, pulled back. Today we hit a high at about 178.50. We pulled back, and I decided to add a bit more money at around 176, 175.90-ish, right around this area. And for those of you guys that don't know, I've actually been in FedEx since about $169.80-ish, about $170 flat. And since it's ran up so quickly since I've entered this position, I actually haven't added more to this position. Today's actually the second scale in that I've put into FedEx. So now I'm in with around 40 to 50% of my goal position. I'm slowly starting to build a pretty solid position now on FedEx. And the continuation at this point will take place, in my opinion, if FedEx does end up gapping up tomorrow and retesting 177, 178, and ultimately hitting another higher high at about 175. But I'm also not oblivious to the fact that FedEx right now is a bit overbought on this one-hour chart, and we might experience a bit of a pullback, maybe back down to 175. So that could definitely happen, but at the same time, we could pop up, and let's say we do maybe pull down to 175 again, 174. I might add there, but it depends, guys. I might take my profits at that point if we start to break heavily. We'll see, and of course, I'll update you guys on these videos, but the goal in this position, as you probably heard me say yesterday and in the previous couple of videos, is that the goal sell price is 185 at this point, right? We broke into the 170 level, which entered us into this new channel, and you guys can see last time we broke into 170, we filled up to about 185 in the matter of a couple of weeks. And right now, again, we're a bit oversold here. We might experience a pullback to 175 again. That could be another entry. And I view that as a dip onto the way of 185, up to 185, where I do plan on selling as of right now. But of course, if things change, I'll let you guys know in the videos. So right now, that's all I ended up doing today, guys, to be completely honest with you. There's a bunch of earnings plays that I was watching that I kind of wanted to keep some cash on the sideline, and I'm seeing one right now that could potentially set up, and we'll talk about that in a couple of minutes here. But first, let me read off these numbers to you for Tesla stock, guys. Tesla ended up not reporting too great of earnings, and you guys can see the stock here is dumping. You all watched my video yesterday, I'm assuming most of you did at least, where we talked about Tesla, you know, and their projected numbers. Well, what they actually reported is, instead of the negative 40 cents of EPS that the analysts were expecting, they actually reported a much wider loss at about negative $1.12 EPS. And you guys can see the stock is reacting to that very negatively. We closed at about $265-ish. We dumped all the way to 233, which is a haircut of around 11-12%. For Tesla stock, and nearly a $35 haircut from this high that we hit after market hours. Their revenue ended up coming in at $6.35 billion versus $6.41 billion expected. And to be quite honest, guys, you know, I like the revenue number, although it did miss. I'm very happy with that revenue number because I forget, let me pull up the notes really quick on my phone. I forget if I even have them on my phone, but that's a pretty strong year-over-year growth and even quarter-over-quarter growth in terms of their revenue. And again, that's mostly due to the very, very high record number of deliveries. I believe it was 95,000 in the second quarter. And of course, that popped up their revenues a lot, as you guys can see from their earnings quarter-over-quarter in terms of revenue. So at this point, guys, if we're going back to the 184-hour chart to do a breakdown on Tesla, in terms of a technical breakdown, you can see now we're very oversold. Now we're getting to a point in time where we're going to retest this 180 SMA on the 184-hour chart and see if we can hold that as a new support. And at this point, guys, you know, since this is oversold heavily, we might see a bit of a bounce back play here, to be quite honest with you, if buyers do start to come in at this 230, 225, 230 level on top of this 180 SMA. And at this point, I think this could be a pretty good dip buy, at least for the short term, before Tesla shakes out. You know, are we going to maybe bounce before continuing the downtrend, or are we going to bounce and then maybe just continue this run and maybe go back up to 250, 260, 270? These are scenarios that can end up playing out, and I want to be a part of it, but I want to see how things end up shaking out first. Are we going to hold this heading into tomorrow? Are we going to break below it? Which if we did, that would be very bearish, guys. You guys can see last time we broke below the 180 SMA, we pretty much trended below it for a couple of months. You know, these are things that I'm watching, but my gut feeling is telling me that Tesla is going to hold right here and maybe for a couple of days shake out before ending up recovering. That's what my gut is telling me, at least. And please, guys, don't just trade this one because I'm thinking about trading it. Do your own DD, do your own due diligence, as always. Understand why you're buying a stock. Understand why you're selling a stock for yourself. Don't judge your decisions based off other people's opinions. So Facebook also reported earnings today. You guys can see the stock has been heavily fluctuating up and down after they reported earnings. And I'm going to read off their earnings right here, their EPS and their revenue. EPS came in at $1.99 versus $1.88 projected by the analysts, which was a beat, very, very good beat there. And revenue came in at $16.9 billion versus $16.5 billion expected by the analysts, which is a beat as well. And that's very good, guys. And you can see after market hours here, if we go to the 20-day, one-hour chart, we're seeing something very interesting in Facebook stock. Take a look at this channel, and I do believe I drew this out in yesterday's video. Take a look at what the stock is doing now after we got this positive earnings report. The stock is breaking out of the resistance of this channel, and we broke out of the 205 resistance as well, and this, in my opinion, is signaling a breakout in Facebook stock. So now I want to see tomorrow if Facebook ends up holding 205 as a new support, and then maybe filling the gap back up to 210, 216. And if you guys remember from a couple months ago, I believe that, actually, no, I'm wrong. That is not the high. That was about a year ago, I believe, right? We were at about 218. You know, at this sort of level a couple of months ago, more like a year ago. And at this point, I would like to see if we hold 205, maybe fill up to the all-time high at about 218, 220. I think that could definitely happen, at least in the short term, if Facebook continues this upward momentum out of the breakout or from the breakout of that downwards trending channel that I just showed you guys, and I'll show you guys again right here, right? So this is interesting. Positive earnings, a breakout could be coming here in Facebook stock. And of course, I would love to know what you guys have to think about Tesla and Facebook. Drop a comment down below. And if you are enjoying this video, guys, hit that like button while you're at it. It does, again, support me and support the channel in general. So PayPal, guys, they also reported earnings, and you can see the stock fluctuated from $122, $121.30 at the close, all the way down to $112. And if we go to the live news tab very quickly to see what the earnings ended up being, you can see earnings per share of 86 cents may not compare to the 73 cent estimate. Sales 4.31 billion missed the 4.33 billion estimate. So they did beat on EPS 0.86 compared to 0.77 or 0.73 rather, but they saw a very slight miss in revenue in terms of their revenue here in terms of the estimate, which is not too bad of a miss as you guys can see those numbers. But if we're taking a look at the performance of the stock right now, you can see we took a huge dip from 122 down to about 112, and now we're recovering, it seems like. Let me just double check that. It seems like we're recovering back to about 115. Yes, it does. So if we go back to the 180, guys, take a look at this trend. It's very obvious at this point. PayPal has been riding that 180 SMA as a support on the 184-hour chart. Notice how that is the level that we're holding right now after market hours, after this earnings report. So I'm interested, tomorrow, are we going to hold this and slowly gap up to 120 again and maybe to 122? That could be a potential play on PayPal right now on this dip. So I'm viewing this as a dip right now on PayPal. If it breaks the 180 SMA, guys, I'm going to scrap it at that point. I'm not really looking to trade it because that's a technical break. But if we hold and continue to hold into the market open tomorrow, pre-market hours, this could definitely open up an entry point. So another stock I want to call out, guys, is 3M. And 3M has been seeing a very impressive recovery ever since its drop from 220 down to about $160. And you can see it very clearly here, guys. You know, over the past couple of weeks, it's been breaking resistance after resistance after resistance. And at this point, we filled the gap from 173 up to about 178. And now it seems like we're holding that level as a new support. And we want to fill the gap back up to 183. That could be the next spot that 3M could fill, and that is what I'm personally watching. But mind you, they do have an earnings call 8 a.m. tomorrow on the 25th of July, so this could fluctuate the stock and maybe fill the gap up to 183, or it could pull the stock back, right? Or it could even not even affect the stock. But that's what we have to watch and keep an eye out for, and from there, I'm personally going to reevaluate the situation, see how 3M is performing, performing after their earnings report. And then maybe I'll get into the position and I'll let you guys know in tomorrow's video. So those are a couple that I'm watching, guys. Facebook, definitely probably the top of my list right now. Tesla, of course, on the dip. 3M and PayPal. These are looking very, very good in my opinion. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. Drop a comment. Let me know what you thought about it. Any thoughts on the stock market right now? And leave a subscription, or rather hit the subscribe button. What am I saying? Leave a subscription. Hit the subscribe button and hit that notification bell so you're notified every single time that I do make a video. And consider joining our Strive Smart Discord group chat, as well as our Strive Smart Facebook group. All of those are linked down below. So I'll catch you all in the next video. Thanks again for watching, guys. It means a lot to me. Peace out.